heroine of this movie cannot accept the rigid rules. While her husband is away, the woman creates the reality she needs. She feels the sweet taste of freedom and decides to fulfill her darkest desires with a stranger. Here you are, Mr. Narrator. Watch on to find out why sometimes things may not go as planned. Enjoy the movie. The movie begins with a wedding ceremony in a church. The young bride Catherine is looking around. At home, a maid named Anna helps Catherine prepare to meet her husband. The girl is excited. A man comes into the bedroom to the young wife. Alexander forbids his wife to go out for walks and ignores the girl's words that she likes fresh air. Instead of actively spending time, the man goes to bed. The wife experiences frustration. During the day, she sits on the windowsill and looks sadly out the window. In the evening, the maid brushes her hair. At night, Catherine suffers from insomnia. This goes on day after day. In the morning, the maid came into the room to open the windows. Tightening mistress's corset, Catherine went down to the drawing room for her usual routine. The Lesters had guests for dinner. Alexander and several other men loudly discussing business by the fireplace. Catherine got bored at the table and said goodbye to the men. Father-in-law followed the girl out into the hallway to admonish his daughter-in-law and ordered her to wait for her husband in the bedroom. To keep the young wife from falling asleep, the elder Lester sent a maid with her. Anna sat beside the girl, reacting to every yawn of her mistress. Alexander went up to the room, kicked the maid out, and ordered his wife out of bed. Catherine laughed at her husband's words, and it irritated him. The man ordered the girl to turn around to the wall to fulfill marital duties. At breakfast, the girl asked her father-in-law about where her husband had gone. The old man did not want to answer the questions. However, Catherine was persistent. The man admitted that there was an explosion in one of the mines, so his son left so quickly. Lester himself is going to London. The father-in-law again expressed the girl's dissatisfaction with her behavior and advised her to rest well during her husband's absence in order to perform her duties better. Catherine took the man's words literally. She was tired of men's prohibitions. Sitting at home all the time was boring, and the girl decided to go out every day while no one was home. One day, when Catherine was dozing on the sofa in the living room, strange sounds reached her. The girl immediately followed to one of the back rooms on the estate. There, the workers were laughing at her maid. The workers said that they were weighing the girl in this way. Catherine wanted to know how much she weighed too. Sebastian lifted the girl in his arms, scaring the heroine. On the way upstairs, the girl learned from the crying maid the name of the employee who behaved inappropriately. At night, all the heroine's thoughts were about that impertinent man. In the morning, Anna reminded the mistress of the order of her husband and father-in-law not to leave the house, but the girl was only angry at the words of the maid. In the field, she met Sebastian, who tried to speak to her. When the girl returned home, the maid tried to warm her in the bathtub. In every action of Anna, the heroine saw the condemnation for disobeying the order of men, and it annoyed her. In the evening, Sebastian knocked on Catherine's room. The girl tried to kick him out of her bedroom, but he unceremoniously entered. The man was a little verbal, and the couple immediately moved to active action. In the morning, Anna noticed the mess in Mistress's bedroom. The expression on the maid's face amused Catherine. The girl decided to continue Sebastian's entertainment before breakfast. A priest stopped by the Lester's house for afternoon tea. Catherine listened to Father Peter's admonitions and was surprised at his conclusion that the girl often walks in the fresh air. After tea, she again decided to do gymnastics with her new friend. In the morning, Anna went to pick mushrooms in the forest where she met Sebastian with a dog. The girl showed the man that she knew about their meetings with the mistress. Later, Anna peeked through the keyhole at the fact that the employee is tumbling with the heroine. The maid informs Catherine that her father-in-law has returned home. The girl is nervous and hurriedly going to meet him, but the man is busy with his business all day. The heroine spends time alone. They meet in the dining room for dinner. Mr. Lester reproaches his daughter-in-law for being a bad hostess. The old man asks to bring him a bottle of wine, but Catherine drank everything from his stock. The man interrogates the maid about where the expensive drink went. As punishment, he makes Anna leave the dining room on all fours. In the morning, the man beats Sebastian and orders him locked up. The heroine cannot find her friend on her own and asks her father-in-law to let the man go. Mr. Lester is angry with his sister-in-law. Catherine's behavior disgraces the family and harms their reputation. Also, the man reproaches the girl for the fact that she has not yet given his son a legitimate heir. The heroine tells her father-in-law that her husband does not show interest in her, and instead of active recreation, goes to bed or relieves himself. The father-in-law is outraged. He slaps the girl and leaves. Catherine alone experiences this scandal. Sebastian regains consciousness on the floor in one of the rooms of the manor house. Anna finds Catherine in the dining room, talking to her father-in-law. The girl insists that the man release her friend. The old man gets angry, throws a glass at the wall, and leaves. The heroine sits down at the table and invites Anna to sit on the chair next to her. The maid is surprised but sits down. Catherine pours tea for the girl and offers to eat. At this time outside the door, Mr. Lester becomes ill. He calls for help. Anna wants to respond, but the mistress orders her to sit down and starts a conversation with the maid about her family. When the sounds outside the door stop, Catherine sends the maid to the village to fetch a doctor. The girl finds Sebastian and tries to heal his wounds on her own. When the doctor arrives at the manor, Mr. Lester can no longer be helped. Anna is tormented by remorse, sobs in her room, and loses her voice. In the morning, a maid brings her mistress a letter from her husband. He informs that he will not come to say goodbye to his father. Catherine and Sebastian have fun and discuss Alexander's deed. The girl is photographed with her father-in-law and accepts condolences from the servants. Later, Catherine dresses up her man, calling him master of the house. Anna brings food for the mistress, but the heroine is not satisfied with the maid's behavior and informs her that another girl will now serve her. Anna shows that she cannot speak and takes the plate with food from the hands of the mistress. In the kitchen, the cook comforts the girl as she helps her prepare the food. Catherine and Sebastian are spending time outdoors. The girl asks her friend if he could live without her and promises to be with him always. In the evening, the couple actively spends time, getting to know each other even deeper. Catherine wakes up in the middle of the night, anticipating the appearance of her husband. She hides her friend in the dressing room and hides the traces of their entertainment. When Alexander enters the room, the girl tells her husband about the latest events in the estate. The man notices that the bed is made for two. Catherine explains this by the fact that her husband did not say exactly when he would return. Therefore, she was preparing for his arrival every day. On the floor, Alexander finds a man's belt. The heroine says that she found it in the fields and kept it. Also, the husband notices that the girl has recovered. Catherine offers him a drink of tea and personally brings the drink to Alexander. After taking a few sips, the man asks how Catherine managed to turn into a fallen woman in such a short time. The heroine is surprised that her husband knows about her adventures. Alexander threatens to lock the woman in the house, reminding her that his father bought the girl. Catherine silently gets out of bed and goes to the dressing room. From there, she brings her friend and offers to show him some gymnastic tricks for her husband. Alexander is outraged by his wife's behavior. He begins to fight with Sebastian, but Catherine comes to the rescue. She takes the life of her husband. The heroine's friend hides Alexander's body in the woods, and the girl gets rid of his horse. The couple lies on the bed and is tormented by insomnia. Sebastian cannot bear what they had to do to save the relationship. The girl convinces the man in the correctness of the decision made, and they begin to stretch their muscles. In the morning, Catherine admires her man. After breakfast, they spend energy together to keep themselves in good shape. Suddenly, a stranger arrives at the estate. Agnes introduces the heroine to Alexander Lester's ward, Teddy. Agnes tells the mistress about the liaison between her daughter and Alexander, which resulted in a boy. Catherine does not believe the woman. The heroine claims that her husband is alive and cannot be the father of this child. The woman asks the maid to bring them tea. Teddy whispers to his grandmother that Catherine is very beautiful. This confuses the girl. However, Agnes is persistent. She has all the necessary papers. The family moves into the Lester house. Sebastian is angry. The man is convinced that Agnes is lying and has forged the papers. He and Catherine quarrel. At dinner, Agnes insists that Teddy be put in Catherine's room, as the girl does not need so much space. The girl agrees and says that she intends to take Agnes' room, as the woman is used to living in a tiny house. In the morning, Catherine feels weak and falls out of bed. She decides to take a walk and in the yard meets Teddy. The boy asks to take him for a walk. Sebastian watches them from the barn. Catherine and Teddy settle in a clearing and the girl tells him about the birds. The boy marvels at how beautiful and intelligent the girl is. Sebastian meets Anna in the woods and asks to keep her company. After the walk, Teddy sleeps on Catherine's bed, and the girl looks at her rounded figure in the mirror. At this moment, Anna enters the room and notices the position of the mistress. At night, Catherine sneaks into the barn, where Sebastian sleeps. The girl wants to spend an active time and tell the man about the baby, but her friend pushes her away. He explains to Catherine why he can no longer come to her bedroom. The next day, the girl observes from the window how in the yard the boy plays with the babysitter. In the open gate, she notices Anna and Sebastian passing by the yard. The girl wants to catch up with the man, but the boy sees Catherine and tries to stop her to show her his progress in the game. He grabs the girl by her skirt, but Catherine roughly pushes him away and the boy runs away. Later, a maid knocks on the heroine's room and informs her that Teddy is missing. The workers of the manor go in search of the boy. Sebastian reaches a mountain stream and sees the child sitting on the rocks. He brings Teddy into the house and asks him to bring a blanket sooner to keep the boy warm. But Agnes chases the man away. Sebastian is angry. He gathers his things. Catherine tries to convince her friend to stay. The man tells the heroine that he could have pushed the child into the water, but he didn't, and the moment is gone. Catherine comes up with a plan B. The girl sends Agnes to rest and stays in the room with the child. She lets her friend in through the window and sits on the boy's bed. Teddy wakes up. Catherine forces the baby to go back to sleep. Sebastian helps her and leaves. The heroine sits on a chair and cries. Anna enters the room. The maid sees what has happened and hurries to fetch Agnes. Meanwhile, Sebastian is crying in the forest, tormented by his conscience. Agnes is suffering. The doctor questions Catherine about what happened in the room when the girl was sitting with the boy. The man noticed bruises on the child's body and wants to know if someone could have entered the room while the girl was asleep. Catherine denies everything, convincing the audience that the boy had gotten bruises at the waterfall. Suddenly, Sebastian bursts into the room. The man admits his guilt and repents. He recounts how the girl acted with Mr. Lester and Alexander. He also describes in detail the previous night and their crime. Sebastian sobs and confesses that he loved her because the girl persistently sought his attention. Catherine looks disappointed at her friend and blames him and Anna for what they did. The heroine tells that the couple walks together in the woods and that her father-in-law had previously beaten the man. Agnes believes the girl. Anna is called in to look into the matter. The girl looks doomed at the gentleman and cannot say anything. Later, she and Sebastian are taken in a cart to prison. Catherine suffers in her room. Agnes leaves the house. Left alone in the house, the heroine goes down to the drawing room, holding her stomach with her hand. Catherine sits down on the sofa and stares doomedly into the void. She is alone. This was a 2016 movie called Lady Macbeth. What would you choose, to live in a golden cage, or would you risk everything for freedom? Write in the comments what you think of the heroine's actions. See you in the next videos.